Now, he famously promised his kingdom for a horse, but what happened to the body of King Richard III after his defeat at the Battle of Bosworth has remained a mystery for more than 500 years. Until now, maybe. Archaeologists in Leicester have been digging in a car park in the city centre. This morning they announced they'd made a discovery that could solve the mystery, as Anthony Bartram explains.
In a quiet Leicester street, crowds gather to hear word of the king. The search for Richard III's final resting place appears to be on firmer foundations today. Beneath a city centre car park, these trenches have revealed the medieval Greyfriars Church, and from there, more evidence has led them to human remains.
We have a man with what appear to be battle injuries who suffered from severe scoliosis, that is, curvature of the spine, respectfully but modestly buried in a place of honour in a friary church.
The team behind this dig say it has been mind-blowing. In just 3 weeks, they've uncovered part of the nation's history, which has been parked here for centuries. So far, the pieces fit with some historical accounts of Richard's death and burial after his defeat at the Battle of Bosworth, and could rewrite many of our history books.
Potentially, it does change everything in terms of study of the real Richard III, not the Tudor myth.
A 17th generation descendant of the king's sister, Michael Ibsen, has given DNA samples to experts, and they hope to match them with the remains. 527 years after Richard's death, we must now wait at least another 3 months to answer the big question. Anthony Bartram, BBC News, Leicester.